And now, direct from 4 weeks of rehearsal in Walter's garage, four guys who have prided themselves on becoming the greatest singing group in the world, Walter, Leon, Terry, and Charlie, the Definition.
No, why I love you like I do. No, why I do. Don't know why I care. I just want your love to share. I wonder why I love you like I do.
Be the next Gianna and the Belmonts.
No, I wouldn't count on it.
Oh, come on. Where's your enthusiasm?
Hello and welcome back to the Good, the Bad, and the Ugly Show. So, as the summer is beginning to end, we feel the days growing colder, the nights getting longer. Winter is descending upon us, and we are entering the season of Halloween. But before we get into that, it's still quite nice, it's still quite sunny, it's not quite there yet. We're in October, but the summer's still kind of happening. It's almost winter, almost Halloween season. I think before we start filling this channel with horror and themes of a darker nature, I think we can still get a few other videos in there, a few lighter ones. We have one about pie coming up. Everyone likes a pie. We also have a slightly drunk Queen review that I'm going to have to seriously re-edit to try and make that watchable. And of course, there is this one. So today, we are going to review a film called Peggy Sue Got Married. It's not the greatest film in the world, not by any stretch, but it's an early Nicolas Cage performance. Also, Jim Carrey's in it, Captain Town.
So, Peggy Sue Got Married. Directed by Francis Ford Coppola, starring Kathleen Turner. With early performances by Jim Carrey and Nicolas Cage, neither had done anything mainstream at this point, though Cage had already won some cult brownie points for a pretty good performance in Rumblefish, also directed by Coppola, and Carrey was in Once Bitten, but let's not get into that. Well, not this time anyway. Anyhow, the plot centres around a woman named Peggy Sue, who, on the verge of divorce, finds herself transported back to her senior year of high school while attending a class reunion.
Blah, blah, blah. I want to suck your blood. I also want to suck your Twinkie.
Am I dead?
No, you are the undead. Come on, let's have it. You hate them anyway.
This is a pretty fun and enjoyable watch, though it's hard not to put this movie in the line of 80s bloomer nostalgia films, as there were quite a lot of them at that point. And with the release of Back to the Future a year before, which certainly holds a stronger position in movie history. Also, what's with Cage's voice?
You mean my wang?
I had a miserable time tonight because of you. When the monotone's the Book of Love, Chapter 4, you break up, won't you give it one more chance? I'm thinking, did we break up? Did we break up?
You and she had a fondness for each other.
She really was a champion for me. You know, at a time when people didn't really see me in that romantic way,
sure.
She fought for me. Now, I don't know why. She saw a movie I made called Peggy Sue Got Married,
sure,
where I talk
with this voice like that.
Yes. And for some
movie.
Reason, she said, "That's my leading man."
She picked you.
She picked me. She said, "I saw you in Peggy Sue Got Married, and it was like watching a train wreck, and I thought you should be my leading man."
Kathleen Turner has stated that it was difficult working with Cage. In her memoir, she wrote, "He caused so many problems. He was arrested twice for drunk driving, and I think for stealing a dog." Classic Cage, I guess.
It was billed as Kathleen Turner's tell-all book. But if Nicolas Cage had his way, she'd have told us a little less. He's just accepted a public apology from her over claims she made in her autobiography. The Oscar winner took offence to Send Yourself Roses, My Life, Love and Leading Roles after the Romancing the Stone actress claimed he was arrested for drink driving twice and stole a chihuahua when they were filming 1986 movie Peggy Sue Got Married. The action was taken in the UK as an extract of the novel was used by the Daily Mail and reprinted on their website. Well, after a high court battle citing defamation, libel and slander, it's Mr. Cage who's come out smelling of roses. Kathleen now accepts the story was defamatory and false and should never have been published. Nick's lawyer said he was extremely pleased to win the case and has never been arrested for road offences, dog napping or anything else. The Hollywood star was apparently concerned that he'd been depicted as someone who condones reckless behaviour. As well as a big sorry, Kathleen's publishers have agreed to insert a correction into her books, and along with associated newspapers, they'll all be making a substantial donation to charity.
So, if you're like me and you can't resist an 80s time travel movie and feel the need to watch everything Nicolas Cage and Jim Carrey have ever been in, then you'll probably want to check this out. As I say, it's actually a pretty fun watch, and Kathleen Turner is also very good in it. But don't take my word for it. Go and check this film out. Please like, share, and subscribe to The Good, The Bad, and The Ugly Show.
Because there's no room left in hell.
Bye.